What is the IRL equivalent of coming back to a RLVL1 dungeon as a RLVL100 character? Going to your first workplace as a customer. Having a PhD in math, and going back to pre-algebra. For a while I was helping evaluate the educational effectiveness of children's games online. Every so often I'd be in a multiplayer game with kids. I stomp those kids. Better believe I know my addition numbers. I can do multiplication too. And you better grow a third hand if you're going to beat me in this typing competition. Farming up XP on Duolingo by practicing your native language. After 5, 10, 20, or 100 plus years of programming experience, when we start to learn a new language, we always start with the Hello World program. Fitting the circle, triangle, and star pegs into their proper places with your eyes closed at daycare. Destroying elementary school dodgeball. Fighting your elementary school bully's child. Climbing the monkey bars when you're now 6 feet 2. Edit, climbing in quotes, because you don't actually hang on, you just smack your hands on the bars as you walk underneath. I would say maximum Verstappen taking his road driving test at 18, having already raced in 14 F1 races. Question mark? Edit, a lot of people have been questioning my answer. Don't forget that going into a level 1 dungeon as a level 100 character, you could still lose. Rather unlikely, but still possible. Going back to daycare and beating everyone in tag. Searching naked boobs on Google Images and not feeling even a flicker of arousal as you browse. Picking up an empty bottle you thought was full and your arm is all like whoa. Going to a class concert of your very first violin teacher after becoming a professional violinist. Coming to university as a mature student and ending up on a pub crawl with kids having their first taste of alcohol-fueled freedom. Drawing in between the lines, be I can create the lines. Edit, added the. Returning to your childhood home before taking your parents to a retirement community. Had a science teacher with a PhD in science. Edit, I don't remember which of the natural sciences he had his PhD in. Okay. This was more than half my life ago. I can't remember, so stop giving me grief for not being specific. And he was a minister. He taught junior high school. He was a level 100 character in a level 1 zone. Wearing diapers when you turn 100 years old. An NHL player playing in a Pee Wee League at the local rink. Attending a high school reunion as the most successful person in your graduating class. Playing that one video game you could never beat as a kid, and realizing the game wasn't that hard, you were just stupid. Climbing a tree. As a kid, it was really difficult and treacherous. Now it only takes 5 minutes, medium effort, and done. Bypassing the Roblox chat filter with obscure curse words or things that sound a lot like curse words, now that you have properly studied. A black belt rolling with a new white belt. Learning to walk as an adult. I had a math teacher who hated my guts in elementary school. Older brother spoiled my last name for her. I ended up getting a math degree, and ended up tutoring a little girl in her current class in the same school. I was tutoring one night and the method the teacher was teaching the kids was asked backwards, so I showed the kid an easy method, and it blew the kid's mind. I casually mentioned that I didn't think her degree was in math, so the kid goes to class the next day and screams to the other kids that the teacher doesn't even have math degree, and started a mini riot in class, which spread to the entire school laughing at her. Strangest level 100 one-edge of my life. Doing maintenance work on a push bike after years of playing around with cars. Moving from a third world country to a first world country, then going back on vacations to visit your relatives. Going through basic training as a private, and then returning years later as a drill sergeant. So I wish I could play Little League now, I'd kick some fain ass. Mitch Hedberg. Dealing with your high school crush that curbed you 10 years later, when you have your shit together and body on point. Going back to elementary school as an adult. Getting your Reddit account banned and having to make a new one. You're a more seasoned Redditor, but everyone sees you as a noob. When I was in first year university, I passed Calculus 1 with a 51%. I pulled up my socks the next year and studied more and got 90% in Calc 2. Fast forward a bit, and I'm told I need a minimum 60% in all my classes in order to graduate in my program. So I ended up retaking first year intro calculus in my fourth year. Needless to say, I spanked it pretty good. Back doing a retail job after 40 years of being a public accountant slash financial planner slash bookkeeper slash manager. Reading children's books. Redoing potty training as an adult. Playing a one-star osu song after getting extremely good. Honestly, any rhythm game. It is your own raw skill and experience that lets you demolish easier maps and no artificial increases. It can feel amazing. When the Lego box says 4 to 12 years, but you eat all of it within 6 minutes. Shopping at the dollar store when you are a billionaire. Walking on a hike and then you find the perfect stick. Banging your ex. When ya couldn't get laid in high school, but then they hire you to teach gym class. My son's kindergarten homework. Completely disregard helping him with it, I showed up to a PTA meeting and helped mandate an entire restructure of the way homework packets are formatted. Heading back to places and towns you visited in your childhood. Failing a class and redoing the whole two semesters. Bringing an M249 to an airsoft war. Going back as an adult to the classroom you had kindergarten in and beating up all the 5-year-olds you find there. Tutoring high schoolers as a university student. Finding an old abusive boyfriend of your mom's and beating his ass once you've become an adult. First grade math. Getting bullied in high school, becoming successful in college slash the real world, then returning to your high school reunion and realizing how small your problems were back then. Had a chief master sergeant, E9, on my base that got busted for drinking at work and having sex with an officer. He got demoted down to senior airman. E4. Getting hired to teach at your old high school. When I was in elementary school, I was very unathletic. I tried to do a pull-up on the monkey bars, fell down, and got the wind knocked out of me. When I was in high school, I started exercising more. At age 18, I went back to the elementary school playground and did pull-ups. Felt like completely trashing the monster that had given me a mortal wound at level 1. Posting on Insta after looking at 4chan. Buying candy as an adult. When you play a video game and you have a RLVL100 char and go back to a RLVL1 dungeon. Becoming the vice principal of the elementary school you attended over 30 years previous. There's one senior member of staff left who used to teach you. You're now her boss. Being a musician and playing Twinkle Twinkle to children. Then you pull out Mozart's variations and you're at the level 40 dungeon. Helping a child with their homework is kind of like hanging around low-level zones to carry noobs through the low-level quests. Someone with a PhD and teaches a kindergarten class. At one point, Steven Spielberg was made aware that he didn't actually have a degree in filmmaking. So he signed up and entered his Oscar-winning Schindler's List as the final project, which normally would be a 12-minute short. Going back to the police station for the second time. Beating your meat after 25 years experience. That woman who just woke up from a 28-year coma slash vegetative state. She was in her 30s, and then she woke up in her 60s. Crazy. Edit, misunderstood the question, thought it meant going straight from level 1 to level 100. Still sort of makes sense. Eating a jalapeno after having eaten a habanero. Revisiting my old middle school. And -X200B. *. I can crush the 7th graders in Dr. Dodgeball *. I have a younger brother who is 10 years younger than me, so I sometimes take him to the same park I went to years ago. There's this slide that, as a toddler, I was terrified of going on because of its height. Now I'm taller than it. TAKR that you find slide.